Coming up next on Jonathan Bird's Blue World, Jonathan heads down to the island of Curaçao to meet up with a friendly dolphin named Annie.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Bird, and welcome to my world. Some say that dolphins are the most intelligent animals in the ocean. Many divers consider swimming with wild dolphins to be the ultimate underwater experience. But finding wild dolphins that will cooperate is no easy task. This is the alternative, the dolphin encounter at the Curaçao Sea Aquarium, where trained dolphins love to interact with swimmers and divers. Curaçao is an island in the southern Caribbean, not too far from the coast of Venezuela. Divers love Curaçao because of the warm, clear water and healthy coral. The Curaçao Sea Aquarium was built in 1984, and one of its biggest attractions is the dolphin program. Not only can divers and snorkelers interact with dolphins here, but they can even take a half-day course to learn how dolphins are trained. Today I'm going behind the scenes to learn from the master, George Kieffer, the head of the dolphin program here at the Sea Aquarium. The day starts before sunrise as George sorts the fish for the dolphins to eat. Each dolphin eats 25 to 30 pounds of herring a day, hand-fed by the trainers. George carefully checks the quality of each and every fish that the dolphins will eat and selects only the best ones. The others go to the shark exhibit.
Basically, we have the rule is in the fish kitchen is if in doubt, throw it out.
Later, I head out to the lagoon to get an introduction to interacting with the bottlenose dolphins.
Rubbery. It's like a wet inner tube.
It's a little silly, but I get to kiss a dolphin.
Yeah, that's what I always say.
Yeah, don't bite.
Lie there.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Hi, buddy.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you heavy?
Yeah, he's heavy. Your hand has that.
Nearby, another group are learning to interact more closely with the dolphins.
Get the mermaid tail before your back. Spit them out.
But my next stop is George's office, where I learn about bottlenose dolphins by taking his hour-long dolphin course. After I become more knowledgeable about dolphin behavior, I'll be ready for my big adventure, a dolphin dive on the reef. Later, I head to the dive boat, where I meet several other divers who are joining me on the dive. George gives us a few last words of advice for the interaction. Underwater, there's no feeding, so the dolphins can choose whether or not they want to interact with the divers. How we act around them will have a huge impact on their willingness to play.
It's okay to touch her fins, the pectoral fins on both sides, the dorsal fin on her back. It's okay to touch those, but don't hold on, don't grab her. She's holding her breath down there, so imagine somebody grabbing you underwater. By late in the dive, she's going to be very comfortable with everybody. She might even swim right up to you, face to face. And if she comes right to you, cup your hands like this. She might just drop her chin right there in your hand and let you rub under her chin. She does like that. Just don't comb your hand over her face.
Finally, we leave the dock and head to the open sea. Somewhere out there, a dolphin is following the boat. Although the dolphins live at the Sea Aquarium, they allow one or two out onto the reef every day to play with the divers and get some exercise. Today, it's a female named Annie. Finally, it's time to suit up and, with a little luck, play with a dolphin.
Okay, next.
Good. Whatever. You ready, Tim?
Ready to go.
I hit the water and immediately start looking all around. I hope Annie is in a playful mood, because if she's not, she might not come and play with us. When the dolphins are out on the reef, they're free to do as they please. But I don't have to wait long. As soon as she hears scuba bubbles, Annie comes over to check us out. It turns out the dolphins love to play with divers. This is one of those times when it's great to be the guy with the huge video camera. Annie is a real ham. She races around me, putting on a show in front of my lens, swooping in, twisting and turning, then zipping around behind me and back to the front faster than I can even turn to keep up with her. The faster I turn to keep up, the faster she swims around me. I'm starting to get dizzy. She seems to be having a great time, but then she leaves. George has jumped in to join the fun, and Annie goes right over to him. George is her pal. This is good news for all the divers in our group, because George comes over and stays with us, so Annie will too. At first, Annie only wants attention from George. He shows us how he's trained her to stick her tongue out. She stays down with us for so long, sometimes I forget that dolphins are mammals and breathe air. Every few minutes, she needs to run to the surface for a breath. But after she gets back with a fresh breath of air, George encourages her to say hello to some of the other divers. Soon he brings her to me, and she stays still so I can touch her soft skin. It feels rubbery and slick, like a wet inner tube. But I can feel her strong muscles underneath that skin. She's a powerful animal, capable of swimming 30 miles per hour, which is really fast underwater. As George introduces her to the next diver, I film the fun and marvel at the incredible relationship Annie has with George. You can just tell they're great friends. Sometimes when I'm in the middle of a shoot like this, I get so involved in being a cameraman that I forget to appreciate the excitement of what I'm actually doing. Not today, because right now I'm doing one of the things that almost all divers dream about, diving with a dolphin, and it's awesome. All too soon, however, the fun has to end. We can't hold our breaths for minutes at a time, so when our scuba tanks get low, it's time to head back to the boat.
Thank you, sir. Got it. Woo! Now that was fun. You know, you can tell the dolphins are kind of used to that shtick. You know, it's like, oh, it's Monday. It's my day to go play with the humans. Oh man, I can't believe it. Can you take my Monday? It does make one point, right? They're captive, but they must not mind it too much, because if you can bring them out on the reef, if they didn't like it, they could swim away, but they don't. So they must find something about it not so bad.
The fact is that the dolphins at the Sea Aquarium were born and raised in captivity, and the hard part isn't keeping them from swimming away, but in fact convincing them to leave the safety of their home and go out on the reef, as George explains.
The easy part of the program is coming back. Going out has always been traditionally the more difficult part of the training, and I think the reason why is coastal bottlenose dolphins are territorial. You know, they don't roam the oceans. They're not like these pelagic species that will, you know, move about through huge swaths of the open sea. Now, these guys adopt a coastline and they stick to it. So what we're doing is, you know, once they've become accustomed to their facility itself, what you're doing is you're sort of exposing them to more area around the facility, and they're co-opting that as their range, their territory.
George also explained that not all of the dolphins like to go outside the Sea Aquarium. Some prefer to interact with people in their private lagoon. I'm so glad to discover that these dolphins are happy and healthy at the Curaçao Sea Aquarium, and especially grateful to one special dolphin named Annie, who came out to play with me, even if it was just for an hour.